Welcome to Grab and Go Info. XLearner is a meta-learner that is an extension of the T-learner. Compared with T-learner, XLearner is better for the dataset with highly imbalanced treatment and control groups. In this tutorial, we will talk about how to implement XLearner manually in Python, how to make an individual treatment effect estimation using XLearner, how to calculate average treatment effect estimation using XLearner. Let's get started. XLearner is consisted of three stages, and each stage has model that estimates different dependent variables. Stage 1 is the same as the T-learner. It builds two machine learning models to predict the outcomes, one model using the treated units and the other model using the control units. After the stage 1 models are built, the imputed individual treatment effect will be calculated. For the samples that receive treatment, the imputed individual treatment effect is the actual outcome minus the counterfactual outcome predicted by the control model from stage 1. For the samples that did not receive treatment, the imputed individual treatment effect is the counterfactual outcome predicted by the treated model from stage 1 minus the actual outcome. Stage 2 builds two machine learning models to predict the imputed individual treatment effect. One model is trained using the treated units, and the other model is trained using the untreated units. After the stage 2 models are completed, the imputed individual treatment effect predictions will be calculated separately using the treated and the control model for all the samples. Stage 3 builds a propensity model to predict the propensity of getting treatment. The predicted propensity score is used as the weight for the individual treatment effect calculation. Finally, the individual treatment effect will be estimated by getting the weighted average of the stage 2 model predictions, using the propensity scores as the weights. To learn how to make an individual treatment effect using a T-learner, please check out my previous tutorial T-learner Uplift model for individual treatment effect in Python. In step 1, we will install and import the Python libraries. Firstly, let's install causalML for synthetic dataset creation. After the installation is completed, we can import the libraries. Pandas and NumPy are imported for data processing. Synthetic data is imported for synthetic data creation. Seaborn is for visualization. LGBM regressor and XGB classifier is for the machine learning model training. To get the code for this tutorial, please check out my blog post on medium.com. I will put the link in the video description. Medium.com is one of the most referenced websites for data scientists. It charges $5 per month for full access. I have been a Medium.com member for many years, and that's the best $5 I spent every month. If you would like to support me to keep providing free content, please use the link in the video description to join the Medium membership at no additional cost. If you prefer not to join, you can still read the post because there are a couple of free monthly posts for everyone to read. Okay, let's continue. In step 2, we will create a synthetic dataset for the XLearner Uplift model. Firstly, a random seed is set to make the synthetic dataset reproducible. Then, using the synthetic data method from the causalML Python package, we created a dataset with 5 features, 1 treatment variable, and 1 continuous outcome variable. After that, the dataset is saved in a pandas data frame. Finally, using value counts on the treatment variable, we can see that out of 5,000 samples, 2582 units received treatment and 2418 did not receive treatment. In step 3, we will process the data for the XLearner. Firstly, the dataset DF is split into 2 datasets based on the value of the treatment variable. The treated units are saved in a data frame called DF treated and the control units are saved in a data frame called DF control. Then the feature matrix and the outcome variable are created for the treated and control data frames separately. Features include X1, X2, X3, X4, and X5. The dependent variable is the outcome column Y. The names of the features are features treated and features control, and the names of the outcomes are Y treated and Y control. Finally, we check the shape of the modeling data for the 2 models. The treated model has 2582 records and the control model has 2418 records. We also need the features for all the samples for the model predictions, and we gave it the name of features. In step 4, we will train the XLearner stage 1 models. 2 machine learning models will be built to predict the outcomes, one model using the treated units and the other model using the control units. The model selection and hyperparameter tuning are important for the performance of an XLearner model. This is because the model performance affects the model predictions, hence the accuracy of the individual treatment effect estimation. Many machine learning model algorithms can be used to build the XLearner models. The model algorithms include but are not limited to lasso regression, ridge regression, random forest, XGBoost, and a neural network model. A light GBM model is used in this example, and the process is the same for other machine learning model algorithms. The models for the 3 stages of XLearner can use different machine learning algorithms. Using the LGBM regressor method, we fit the 2 XLearner stage 1 models using the features and the outcome variable for the treated and the control group separately. In step 5, we will make predictions using the XLearner stage 1 models to get the counterfactual outcome predictions. To make the treatment effect estimation, 2 separate predictions need to be made using the trained stage 1 models. In the first prediction, the treated model is used for the prediction of the control group. This gives us the predicted outcome values if the control group received the treatment. In the second prediction, the control model is used for the prediction of the treatment group. This gives us the predicted outcome values if the treatment group did not receive the treatment. In step 6, we will train the second stage models on the imputed individual treatment effect. The imputed individual treatment effects are calculated for the treatment group and the control group separately. For the treated group, the imputed individual treatment effect is calculated by using the actual outcome minus the counterfactual outcome predicted by the first stage control model. For the control group, the imputed individual treatment effect is calculated by using the counterfactual outcome predicted by the first stage treated model minus the actual outcome. After getting the imputed individual treatment effect, we will run the second stage X-learner models. In the second stage models, the dependent variable is the imputed individual treatment effect, and the features are the 5 covariates. Two models will be built to predict the imputed individual treatment effect, one using the treated group and the other using the control group. In step 7, we will use the X-learner second stage models to predict the imputed individual treatment effect. Two values will be predicted for each unit in the dataset, one using the second stage treated model and the other using the second stage control model. The prediction results are saved in the data frame that includes both the treated and the control units. In step 8, we will build a propensity score model to predict the propensity of getting the treatment. The dependent variable is the treatment, which has two values: 0 represents the untreated unit and 1 represents the treated unit. The predictors are the 5 features. We can use any binary classification model to do the prediction. In this example, we will use XGBoost to illustrate the process. Please see my previous tutorial Hyperparameter Tuning for XGBoost for more details about the XGBoost model. In step 9, we will use XLearner to calculate the individual treatment effect. XLearner individual treatment effect is the weighted average of the second stage predictions on the imputed individual treatment effect. The authors of the XLearner paper suggested using the propensity score as the weights when the treatment group and the control group have similar sizes. When the treated group is very large or very small compared with the control group, we can use 0 or 1 as weights to utilize the model results with the larger size. Since our dataset is relatively balanced between the treatment and the control group, we will use the propensity score as the weight. The weights for the second stage control model predictions are the propensity scores, and the weights for the second stage treated model predictions are 1 minus the propensity scores. When there are a lot of control units and only a few treated units, most units have low propensity scores, so the second stage treated model gets more weight. Because the second stage treated model is based on the first stage control predictions, we are utilizing a model that has more data. Similarly, when there are a lot of treated units and only a few control units, most units have high propensity scores, so the second stage control model gets more weight. Because the second stage control model is based on the first stage treated predictions, we are utilizing a model that has more data. If you would like to learn more details about the intuitions behind the XLearner, please refer to the paper MetaLearners for estimating heterogeneous treatment effects using machine learning. After calculating the individual treatment effect, the data is saved in a data frame. The histogram visualization of the individual treatment effect shows a normal distribution. The average treatment effect is around 0.5. Most individuals in the dataset have a positive treatment effect. Some individuals have negative treatment effects. In step 10, we will estimate the average treatment effect using the XLearner predictions. The average treatment effect for the population is the average of the individual treatment effect. We can see that the average treatment effect is 0.57. To learn more about the definition and calculation for the average treatment effect, please check out my previous tutorial 8 vs. Kate vs. ATT vs. ATC for causal inference. The customer segmentation using individual treatment effect from the XLearner is the same as the TLearner and the SLearner. For the details about how to segment customers, please check out my previous tutorial SLearner Uplift model for individual treatment effect and customer segmentation in Python. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about the Uplift models, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.